My name is Robert Johnson. I am a captain with the Office of Motor Vehicle Enforcement for the Department of Transportation. I have been in law enforcement for 30 years now. I started my career with Cedar Rapids Police Department, and I also work for the Iowa Department of Corrections. From Cedar Rapids Police Department and Corrections, I went to Department of Transportation Motor Vehicle Enforcement. I also work part-time for Britt PD, Barner PD, Mason City Police Department, and I've worked for the Polk County Sheriff's Office. I've done quite a few things, I guess, over my 30-year career. So I'd like to share a little bit about motor vehicle enforcement. Let's talk a little bit about the history of motor vehicle enforcement. It's been around since 1941. Started out as the old Highway Safety Commission. Then it kind of evolved from there with traffic operations, which tasked to do weight operations, along with the Department of Revenue with collecting fuel tax from big trucks. And then the Commerce Commission is authority, so trucks have to have authority to run through the state of Iowa. We were part of the Department of Public Safety or the State Patrol, and we were a unit within that department. Our main function is commercial motor vehicles, but we are state peace officers. So we work not only with commercial motor vehicles, we work with cars as well as anything else. And that doesn't limit the power of any other law enforcement agency. Any other law enforcement agency can also stop trucks. We are highly trained in that. We are the experts with the truck. So since we're certified with that, our unit really doesn't even need probable cause to stop a truck, a commercial motor vehicle, because they are a regulatory unit, and they are known that they know that they are going to get stopped. So a little bit about MVE. We have a Bureau of Investigations. We call those the BIPs. They have a director, assistant director, and roughly about 22 investigators throughout the state of Iowa. They do identity and identity theft, car thefts, all different types of things is their main focus. Those guys are soft clothing. We call them soft clothing, so they're not in uniform. And then our office, we have... We have one chief, and now actually we have one assistant chief. We did have two majors, but we took that other position and moved that to another slot within the department. We have six captains, roughly two or three lieutenants, 12 sergeants, and over 90 officers. So what exactly does motor vehicle enforcement do? Just to kind of reiterate, anything that you see here on the screen is a commercial motor vehicle, whether it's hazardous materials, whether it's construction, whether it's agricultural, or whether it's dry bulk. As you can see, that top truck over to the left, the blue truck and trailer is something that you normally see all the way down to your bottom right, which is, back this up. How that happened. All the way down to the bottom right, what you see is your car hauler. So those are all commercial motor vehicles. Those are all regulated vehicles that are subject to be inspected. And that's what our officers do. Okay, so these are all commercial motor vehicles, and we regulate each one of these. The top left truck is a semi tractor trailer that you normally see on the roadway, all the way down to the bottom left, or excuse me, the bottom right-hand corner that you would be looking at, which is a car hauler and all these vehicles in between. Again, some of these vehicles transport hazardous materials. Some of them transport livestock. Some of them transport construction materials. Some of them are rolling machinery. So all these things are what we regulate to make sure that we have safety on the roadway, because we know that if any one of these vehicles were to get into an accident, the potential for death is very, very, very high because of how large these vehicles are. We also stop non-commercial motor vehicles. So we stop cars, pickup trucks, you name it. We do have a division within the Department of Transportation. It's an aviation division. We assist them too as well with planes, helicopters, and the things of that sort. We are the lead MCSAP agency. So we do partner with the Iowa State Patrol. They have a unit of troopers that go out and stop trucks as well. And we combine all the information and we take that information and put in a report and submit that to the federal government every year. To be an officer, you have to go through the academy for 14 weeks. You have to pass through that. You have to also go through a two-week North American Standard Inspection School, a one-week basic hazardous material inspection school, and a one-week cargo tank and bulk tank inspection school as well. So as you can tell, it takes quite a bit of time to actually kind of figure out what you're doing. We surmise that most officers, it will take them roughly about 2 years before they know exactly, you know, or feel comfortable with what they're doing in our department. So one thing that I really liked about coming to motor vehicle enforcement is the fact that when I was in Cedar Rapids Police Department, I was traffic, so I worked 2:30 to 10:30 traffic unit. And so basically when you stop a vehicle, it's license, registration, and proof of insurance. With motor vehicle, it's so much more because there's a lot more into stopping a commercial motor vehicle. And it's very detailed, and I like the challenge of being able to go through that. Kind of talking about the skills that you would need. My educational background is, once I graduated high school, I went to the University of Northern Iowa, and I ended up getting married, and so that was the end of that, and plus I had kids. I ended up having some children, so I later went on back to the University of Iowa with going to Kirkwood in the middle of that. So with us, you don't actually have to have a degree, but it certainly helps, especially if you want to move up the ladder. We like a diverse background, so we like to see people who have a lot of life experiences, and college is definitely a part of that. I would always recommend that you go through and get your degree. Once you start it, don't stop. Just go through and finish it because it will help you in the long run. Some of the things that we like as far as the life skills is just good sense of common sense. Being an officer, one thing that we're looking at now is people who care about other people. I think that's imperative for us when we do our hiring. We want people who have common sense. We want people who are able to learn quickly, make decisions on their own. And we like people who really have a sense of caring for other people. So we look at your background and we like to see people who are out in the community and doing community work and helping other people. And just really showing that, you know, they do very much care about other people. If I could go through, and if you guys are, you know, you're looking at where do you want to go, you know, what do you want to do with your life, and that sort of thing. If I could give you any type of advice whatsoever, I would say that you really want to make sure that you, if and when you decide what you want to do, you want to start preparing for that at that moment. If you want to be a police officer, then you want to start preparing for it right at that moment. Because when we do our background checks and we do our interviews, we do all those types of things. Even when we back it up, when you come to test for us and you have to do the running test and push-ups and setups and sit and reach, we're watching you from that moment. We want to see how you hold yourself, how do you speak to others, how you dress, how you act, how you react. All those things, and we're making mental notes And we make mental notes of people who are, who we think are impressive and people who we feel like aren't ready for this position, because when you wear this badge, there's a lot that comes with it. And we want to make sure, you know, strongly that we get the right people on board. So when you decide what you want to do, you want to, at that moment, start preparing for that in your life. There's a couple things that I really want to bring out. The number one, well, the first thing I want to bring out is make sure you keep yourself in good shape. A lot of people will not be able to pass the run, because you do have to run a mile and a half. A lot of people won't be able to pass the push-ups, because you do have to do a certain number of push-ups or setups. A police officer should be in good shape. They should keep themselves in good mental and physical shape. And that's part of it. That's one thing that you have in control of yourself. You should never go and test and not make the physical portion of that testing. The next thing that I would say is, once you advance into this, we do a 7-day background investigation. I kind of talked about that a little bit earlier, but we go through every single thing that we possibly can. State Patrol does the exact same thing. And I know a lot of the other agencies are doing that as well, but this background check is very extensive. We want to know everything that we possibly can about you. And the goal is really to find something that precludes you from moving further in the process. If we can't find that, then we know that you're going to be a good, solid candidate, and you'll be able to move forward. So that's something that, it's just paramount. And the one thing that we do find, especially with a lot of our younger people and people in general, is social media. We do look at your social media, because that's what it is. It's social. People, it's there for people to look at. And if you don't carry yourself in the proper way, and you're doing things that, you know, may be illegal if you're underage and you're drinking, or, you know, smoking or doing different types of things, drug use and that sort of thing, can back to haunt you. So you really want to make sure that you're trying to live, you know, an exemplary life, where you're living, you know, what you want to be, and you're bringing yourself up to those standards right off the bat. And you definitely want to take a look at your social media to make sure you're not displaying yourself in a less than good life. Some of the challenges that you're going to face now, in the world that we live into now, it's not everybody likes police officers. And we know hopefully that'll change. It like a roller coaster. Roller coasters go up and then they go down, and they go up and they go down. And we'd really like to see our roller coaster go back up again, maybe stay there. But that's some of the challenges that you're going to face, that not everyone is going to approve of your choice to be a police officer. And that's okay, but there are still a lot of people who do approve of that, and still a lot of people who do respect you as a police officer. And that's just something that you just have to maneuver around, and you still have to treat those people with the utmost amount of respect and show them that, hey, you know, I'm not a bad cop. Not all cops are bad. And this is a good agency, and we are here to serve and protect. We are a part of your community. And you have to start thinking that way and displaying that. So those are the things that I think that are really paramount that we should know. Thanks for having me. I wish you all the best of luck in your careers, whatever you decide to do. Be the best at it and do the best that you can. Thank you.